It was at the bank premises after parking a car at the car park. So my way coming back. Now saw money close to $10,000 close to the security gate. It was only me. When I picked it, so I went to the office. I sat a little, like 3 minutes. I 10 thoughts just came on me, and those 10 thoughts, 8 of them, you know, asked me to return the money. Why 2 of them said, "This is money. Why don't you take this money?" The 8 now supersede the other 2 that thought. So I have to return the money to my BOMD, the branch operation manager. Later on, the customer who the money belongs to now came and claimed the money.
Was money in a bag?
No, it's $10,000. Just
a bunch, a packet. Was there any camera looking towards the area?
No. Though a lot of people have asked such questions. You know, I have had this argument with some friends when a lady at the airport, Josephine Ubu, picked a 12 million naira at the airport. So we were in form of a discussion, talking, and I said, "These are the kind of things I like doing." And those my friends were arguing with me and said, "Can you do it? You cannot do it." I said, "These are the kind of thing I like doing, because it's not only one person's name that should be going into a paper, and people should be knowing, so people, that these are people that have been doing good thing for a very long time." It's unfortunate, it's just that it's a form of a test that God gave to me, that if you say you can do this, do it, let's see. That was what I did.
Are you sure you are not paid $10,000 as salary in your bank?
My salary is just 30,000. Yes.
When the management heard about this, what was done? I saw your picture with Tony Elimelu.
Oh yes.
So what happened?
When a mail was sent to him from my branch, you know, he now set a meeting between me and both of us. I met him. He was so happy. You know, he was so happy. He was even the first person that tweeted the information out. So he was so happy that he have such a person close to him. That such thing has not happened to him since he had been born. That is the first time such a thing has happened. I was glad. It's a welcome development. And I was so happy meeting him, Tony Elumelu, and I appreciate him.
So nothing was given?
No. A lot of people are equally asked the question. And I told them that if it is money, you know, it was not the same money I returned back. I picked money and I returned it back. I did that to refine my name, so that my name will be written in the Guinness Book of Records. Just and last time when I had David Cameron, the former British Prime Minister, that said that Nigeria is fantastically corrupt. You know, a person like me, I would like to put him to shame that it's not all Nigeria. Though some Nigerians may be corrupt, but not all Nigerians. You know, and that is what I did. It's in me, it's part of me. I am a human being, you know, and I should be having such a thought, you know. But my joy is what Tony Elimelu did, you know, by twisting it out. You know, if it is an ordinary person that sends such an information, you know, people will not grab it on time. It will look as if it's a form of maybe a joke or something. But when a high caliber of person, you know, twisted such a thing to the public, you know, it's enough. He has marked me. What do I say? Marked me. No.
Are you married?
No.
If you're married, do you think your wife will agree with that?
Huh?
If you're married, do you think your wife will agree?
It should, because any wife I'm going to marry, which I'm processing it, should know whom I am. You get it now. So any wife I'm going to marry should know whom I am, and should know that this is the kind of person I am going to marry.